Blizzard here, and welcome back to another Minecraft video on Pixelmon. And today, I am in Seatopolis City, in Hoenn, on Polk Central, and I need to go find Groudon. Because if you remember in the last video, I came to Seatopolis City after taking ages to find the Seafloor Cavern, and I beat Maxi and Archie, and then I came to Seatopolis. And Sebastian told me that a cave has opened. So the cave of origin is over here. So I'm not sure if I'm supposed to go in. Hi there. Am I supposed to go in? I'm not supposed to be going in. So maybe I just have to find Groudon. So yeah, I'll just do that because he did say that it might be on the outside of Seatopolis. I'll see if I can go talk to him again. But as far as I remember, I think he said that I need to go to the outside of Seatopolis. Let's see what he said. I'm Sebastian. Didn't say anything. Well, let's look for any of us, because it'll be better if I'm out looking for him instead of just talking. Well, I'm still going to be talking, but oh, there's someone over there. This is why you should have a rank. So let's just look for... Nope, it's not on that island. Wait, is that a sky pillar? I think that might be the sky pillar, which is... In a making of the Sapphire, like, the sky pillar has a really good story. Because that's where you find the equator, but I doubt Rodan's going to be over there. So let's go. Oh, there we go, found it. That honestly wasn't as hard as I thought. It wasn't as hard as finding Seafloor Cavern, definitely. Right, so I'll use a super potion so I can use an attack from Golem. Alright, I've used a super potion. So, yep, it has a blue L on it, so that means I have to attack it, so I won't attack from the behind, I'll just attack from the front. So let's fight him. Alright, so this might be hard. It's probably going to be the hardest fight I've ever done. So, Heavy Slam. Got me to one because I have 30. Now it's going to kill me though. Yep. Alright, next. Gyarados. Try to get an Aqua Tail off. Sceptile, that's a quick claw one, so Leaf Blade, quick claw didn't work. Gardevoir, use Psychic. Oh, critical hit, probably would have killed me anyways. I'm not going to be able to beat this. Double Kick. I forgot, not flame charge. Oh, well, he is visible blaze. Anyways, that was so hard. Oh, that guy there lost the battle with me. That was really difficult. I'm not going to be able to read that for a while. Alright, so I'll just end it here then. So that's a killing moment. I may as well do some training then, because I don't want to make this a 4-minute video. 4-minute. Video. So, wait, let me just check something. Alright, so I just looked at Whispin's video and he didn't beat it either. So he went to the Pokemon League and trained. So I'll do that as well, because why not? Better than uploading a 5-minute video for people to like see me lose a fight. So I'll do a bit of leveling up and then I'll fight Groudon at the end of the video. But that was a really hard battle. Whispin actually had to use Destiny Bond, and that didn't work because his Frost Blast, I think, wasn't fast enough. Alright, so let's fight some Pokemon. Here's a Golbat, and I will use Renekton. Right, so, I'll do a bit of leveling up. Oh my god, guys! I found a shiny Hariyama. Oh my god. I don't want to kill it. Hopefully I can paralyze it. Right, it's paralyzed. Right, how much damage will one crunch do? But I mean by... Not much. I don't want to kill this. I don't want to kill this. I'll just keep using bite. Then I'll send out Gyarados, and I'll use Crunch with Gyarados. But I do not want this thing to die. Alright, Gyarados. Crunch shouldn't kill it. Alright, that didn't kill it. I can use it one more time. Alright, should I use a Pokeball now? I'll use an Ultra Ball. Oh, I don't have any Ultra Balls. I'll use Great Balls. Until I catch it. I am not going to let this thing leave. Oh, caught it in my first Great Ball. Alright, now I'm going to go check it out. I'm actually like really hyped that I caught it. That guy probably wanted to catch it as well. That was so lucky though. That's the second shiny I found in this, so. Woohoo. No, I do not want to fight you. Alright, so let's go look at this Hariyama. I'll see you when I find it. But that was really lucky. That was extremely lucky. I'm pretty sure it's like a 1 in 8,192 chance in this. Or it might be 4,096, but I'm not exactly sure. But I'm gonna go have a look at its stuff, and I might replace another Pokemon. I probably won't, but I'll see. Because if it's really good, I might consider replacing another Pokemon. If it's Adamant or Jolly, I will. I'll think about it. If it's not Adamant or Jolly, I'll just leave it in the PC. But that was extremely lucky, though. Alright, PC. Shiny Hariyama. Gentle. That's not the best, but let's see if I have these. 60%, 1 HP, and 31 special attack. That's not that good, honestly. I wish it was, because I would rather use it, but it's not. It's honestly not that great. But I do have 3 shinies now, so. Including Sceptile. So that's quite good. And I've barely gained levels, I've basically gained no levels. I think Gardevoir's gained 1, but other than that, I haven't. I've been battling like that Mr. Goat, 345 guy, and he was good. He had a level 64 Swampert, I think, which is quite high. He's probably training for the league, and I'm not gonna like really criticize. I'm gonna try not to criticize, but the Pokemon here like aren't that leveled, aren't that high leveled compared to the Elite Four and like most Pokemon games. I ought to be in a shiny. I'll cry if it was. I don't think there's any more shinies, but now on I'm like gonna pay close attention to shinies. But that was extremely lucky with Hariyama. I just jumped down after blacking out, and what do you know, shiny Hariyama. Alright, let's go fight this street thug vegan guy. He's a Houndoom, that shouldn't be too difficult. It's fast, oh it burnt me, as soon as I said that, and it, oh. Heavy slam? I didn't do that, oh okay, I shouldn't knew that was gonna happen. Alright, shift B, so Blaziken, should use Flame Charge and beat it. And now this Graveler wants to fight. But I don't... Oh, it has Sturdy. It's fine though, because now it's dead. Right, let's fight this Golbat with Discharge. Alright, except I leveled up from that. Alright, so I'll just keep leveling up and probably won't see any more shinies, but if I do, I'll see ya then. So guys, I've done a bit of training and I've got my Pokemon a bit more high leveled up. I don't think I'll be able to beat Groudon yet, but they're a bit more higher leveled than they were at the beginning. So I'll go take on Groudon again. Can I ride Sceptile? Yes, I can. I thought I'll ride it to Seasopolis. So hopefully I can beat it now, but if I can't, I'll train a lot more outside the video. So let's go back to Seasopolis. Alright, so first I need to heal. Because if you look on the left, my Sceptile only has 27 HP left and everyone else is dead. So I should probably heal. That would be the most likely solution of healing. That didn't make sense. Alright, so wait, where did I find Groudon? I'm pretty sure it was like over there. But let's just go this way. I'll ride Sceptile for once instead of Golem. And so Sceptile, like, this looks the same, doesn't change that much when you're riding it. Its model is quite cool though. Alright, so it should be somewhere down here, that way I think. I can't exactly remember, I think it's here. Yep, there it is. Alright, so I'll just keep going this way. And I won't ride Golem because I don't want his Sturdy to get removed like it did last time. It's Sturdy can really help. Alright, so I'll make Golem first again. Alright, so if I run away actually. No, I can't run away. Earthquake. That didn't do that much damage, but it's fine, because Earthquake again. And this should hopefully it gets paralyzed after it fights me. I'm not sure if it got paralyzed or not. Yeah, I don't think it did. So, Magical Leaf. Oh no, it's faster than me still. Leaf Blade, no. Aqua Tail. Yes, I landed in Aqua Tail. Gyarados doesn't affect me. I mean, Earthquake doesn't affect me. I beat it! Yes! Alright, cool. That is actually really good. So, return to the Seafloor Cavern and speak to Team... Okay. I have to go back to Seafloor Cavern. So I will do that now, and I can't because my Pokemon are dead. Okay, that is Kyogre. That actually sort of scared me when I seen it, but Kyogre's over there. Don't think I need to fight it yet, and I'm lagging a lot, so I'll reload the chunks. And I'll see you when I'm back at Seatopolis. Oh, wait. How do I revive outside of battle? I need to figure out how to revive outside of battle, wait. Okay, oh. So, the first Pokemon in your party gets revived. I see. Alright, so I'll, I don't need to skip until I get there anymore, I think, so I'll just go back to Seatopolis, which is down here. And I'll use the boat to get to Moss Deep, because I need to go back to Seafloor Cavern, and it'll just be faster if I just walk to Moss Deep. So there's the boat. And I'm pretty sure that you don't need a rank to use the boat, and you, so you can have like any rank. and you can use the bot just fine. So that's good for people who don't have ranks. And before I go back to Moss Deep, I need to heal. So I'll heal. Alright, now that I've healed, we've got no other choice than go back to Moss Deep, because I can't really fight the gym yet when there's like... Groudon's calmed down, but I can't really go back yet since Kyogre is still like really angry for some reason. Oh, well, that's what the myth says. Oh no, I fell. How do I get back up? Oh no. Wait, this might not work actually. This worked the last time, but I don't think this will work again. Nope, that's not gonna work again. Alright, Tiptile, let me ride you again. Let's just go this way. And hopefully not fall into the water this time like an idiot, because that's not good. Alright, Captain's down. Take me to Moss Deep. The first one. Thank you. Alright, I'll have to... Can't exactly remember what, coast it was. So hopefully... I'm pretty sure it was this one. I'm like 95% sure it was the one to the right to the ship. The one to the right to the ship, that is quite a mouthful. Alright, Sceptile. And let's go this way. And if I'm right, it should be down here, the cavern. And I swear, hopefully I don't have to battle Archie or Maxie again, because that'll be quite annoying. And I don't really want to deal with battling them again. Alright, let's talk to Maxie. You beat Groudon. I was right to assume you were the most suited for this job. We as Team Magma definitely owe you one. Take this as a reward, if you don't mind. I suggest speaking to Team Aqua Leader Archie next. Kyogre can be just as dangerous as Cloud. Oh, I'm gonna use all these in my next trick. Because it needs a few levels. I charge, don't need that. Cool. And now my next trick's my highest level Pokemon. Hey Archie, what? You went and defeated Groudon? ... Maxie asked you to. He's very serious this time. ... Well, could you help a pirate out and defeat Kyogre too? Without Groudon, it'll just rampage. Alright, sure. I'll do that in the next video though. So yeah, and in between videos, I'll try to get all the Pokemon to like level 52 maybe? Around level 52. Alright, so I'll end it at Moss Deep when I get back, obviously. Alright, go on, Sceptile, let me ride you before I run out there. Thank you. Alright, so Moss Deep's like not far from the Seafloor Cavern at all. It's a really good thing that Maxie gave me 5 air candies, because they really helped out. Well, haven't yet, but they will, because level 48 did it better than level 43's. I was still going to do 48 minus 45 for some reason. So where's the Pokemon Center? I'll just end the video outside the Pokemon Center. So yeah, that's the end of the video, guys. Hope you all enjoyed. Bye.